Hello, and welcome to Clamato Time with Picante. Oh, I love this tomato juice. I like to make it like a Bloody Mary. I'll put celery, salt, Worcestershire. I'll put hot sauce in there, pickle juice, olives. Oh, I'll load it up and drink it. I'm in heaven. I don't need alcohol. I love tomatoes in any form, but it's Clamato Time. I'm going to start with a little jingle. You have got to download the Smule. It has two microphones and a purple app, and start singing along. I am horrible at singing. I don't read music. I don't know anything about it, but I love to sing along. And I can tell when I'm horrible and what songs fit me. So you can try on a song or two without messing around with the band, Lena or Kelly. Here you go. This is You Don't Bring Me Flowers. I'm just going to start it out, and then I'm going to start Coffee Time with Lena and Kelly. How are you guys doing? It's just after the 4th. Come on. Do it. This is a duet. I did it because it's free to do duets. Otherwise, you have to pay for a membership. But it's Smule or Sing.
You don't bring me flowers. You don't sing me love songs.
You hardly talk to me anymore. When I come through the door at the end of the day,
I remember when you couldn't wait to love me. Used to hate to leave me.
It's good for you, babe, and you're feeling all right.
Well, you just roll over.
All right, that's enough. That's enough. I Got You Under My Skin. I did a whole bunch of other ones. Some are okay. Some are I can tolerate. But the app is called Smule. How are you guys doing? Here's my... I don't really like the really. Oh, look at my tongue. Lena, I got this new cup for you. And I spent a whole bunch on it. It's Portobello by Inspire, and it's from England. It's Bone China. I got it at my favorite store. I can't wait to send it. So now I'm backlogged by two coffee cups, the one from Frozen and this one. And what I found for you. My sweet little twin that hates me. Look, it's that straw. It's not so long. It kind of has Mardi Gras colors. It comes in a cute little case. And then it's got the little cleaner. I cannot wait to get it to you. I have a gut feeling it's going to be sooner rather than later. The other day, I'm sure you saw my Facebook site. But if you didn't, I was open in the morning. I always have eggs. And I cracked some eggs, and I got a double yolk, a twin egg. I've never had that. I mean, if you're on a farm or something like that, it's pretty common. But to buy grocery store eggs and to get a double yolk is pretty unique. And I hope that's a sign. So I hope you guys are doing well. I have fake eyelashes on. They took me an hour. It was a waste of time. But what I ended up doing was putting the black glue that you use on my liner. It was all gunky. And then wait a few minutes and then shoved these on it. So one's a little bit higher than the other and whatever. So, and I curled my hair. I did everything and I look horrible. I don't care. It's the way I look. So I wanted to share with you. I'll give you a couple of jokes. I thought about them. One of them, I wrote it on my Facebook, is... I remember someone saying, imagine what it'd be like if there were no men in the world. And someone said, yeah, there'd be a lot of fat, happy women around. And I thought, oh, that's hysterical. I try to manage my weight, and I'm going to tell you about a diet if you guys are dieting. But I typically am not that concerned about it until I'm in a relationship, especially if my body is going to be seen. Then I really care. Otherwise, you can pretty much cover up everything. So It rings true. One of my other favorite, it's really not a blonde, you could say red hair, you could say anything, but I love this joke. What do you call, I'll say blonde for just for me, what do you call blonde skeletal remains in a closet? Hide and go seek champion. Either you go, or you're like, what? They hide so long that they die and become skeletal. So, ha, 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 there we go. And my other one is a bumper sticker that says, where are we going and why are we in this handbasket? I hope you guys are happy and well. I paid attention. New Orleans had like 957, no, deaths, was that it? I'm so fixated on who's dying, whose numbers are going up, who got out of it clean. I'm somewhere where the numbers are very low and hunkering down. And I've already been tested. I knew I was negative, so I'm just steering clear of human life. My big event is going shopping. And I'm I'm a beef eater. I'm an O positive. And Dr. Domino, I think it is, Eat Right for Your Blood Type. That was one of my first diets. And he talks about O blood type as being the original oldest blood type. They were hunters and gatherers. And in order to catch their food, their elk, whatever, they would kill and run after it and get their blood boiling. And then they'd eat all this meat. And so as we adapted and moved into Asia and they started to farm and they had a more sedentary lifestyle, their blood type actually changed and they discovered A blood types. And those people do quite well on a vegetarian diet and yoga, much more casual exercise. But the O blood type, Lena, O positive, how do I know that? I'm like a fortune teller. O blood types really need blood boiling exercise. They can't get away with passive stuff. And they need meat. And so I'm a meat eater. I had a steak this morning for breakfast. So you guys were talking about a new diet. And I'm on this website. And it's the keto diet. And really at the grocery stores, there's tons of keto ice cream and everything. You just have to eat really bad and give up on, carbs, the breads, and I don't know why you aren't or if you've never been tested, Lena, but I have celiac disease. So I'm very, very allergic to gluten. And I can, as soon as I eat it, I have psoriasis and I am covered. And I've taken shots and Humira and all these medications in the past. And I went 4 days. I had shrimp, I had steak, I had cod. I just did not have gluten. I had, rice and potatoes. And in 4 days, my skin was transformed. And so I've tried to, but if I go to In-N-Out Burger, I'm going to eat the bun. I'll pay for it afterwards, but I'm stubborn that way. So anyway, this keto diet, people really go on the website. They have a website. I wish I had the exact name for it. I'd give you it. But they give recipes. Like one of my favorite, Miss Italian, one of my favorite breakfast things is I grate zucchini and I grate onion and maybe garlic in there, Parmesan cheese and a couple of eggs and stir it up. And I make little patties, and I make sure they're really crisp. And then I put marinara because I love tomatoes. Anything tomato. I don't ever go to the store and not pick up something, either spaghetti sauce or an extra tomato. I've grown tomatoes. I love heirloom tomatoes. So I put marinara on the top, sometimes some extra like mozzarella. And I'm in Italian breakfast heaven. Unfortunately, I'm not Italian. My mother, Gia, is Swedish, Scottish, Irish, ish, you can ask Grace. And our father is Northern European, but I was raised to appreciate and make Italian food, and I make a lot of it. But the Italian blood is not coursing through my veins. I might have a small percentage, I forget. But you would know this if you did Ancestry.com, or if you did 23andMe. You'd send it in. You'd probably match up with Anderson Cooper because he's a cousin of ours. And so that was a surprise that with my son and myself. But also you discover some other surprises, maybe that you had a twin sister or something. So I hope you guys are doing well. Let me see. So I showed you all my stuff. I went out and bought nails because you showed off. And I got these ones. I like the coffin shape, you know, more tapered. And these had that ombre or whatever kind of a, can you see? They have a lighter kind of a French tip, but it faded in. They lasted 2 days. I'm not doing nails again, Lena. I like to go and have them done, but like you, my nails tend to hike up. So when I have them done professionally, in a week, the nails are ski lift off of my nail bed. I've got tiny little nails. My toes are even smaller. As a matter of fact, my baby toe on both feet is jammed. It's like crooked jammed. And you just have to take a little polish and dip it on there. That's how you paint it. I bet you have the same toes, Lena. How do I know that? Really high arch on my roof of my mouth, tiny teeth, and very high arch on my feet as well. Isn't that interesting how I could know all that? Tell you more? Anyway, so what I wanted to share with you today is that for reasons I really can't explain, I have 120 views at the same time that you guys, you professional singers and in the industry for all these years, don't have that many hits. But for some reason, I can sit in a crappy old cheap hotel room in my same pajamas, I've got dog hair on them, and lots of people want to see. You know why? Because they know I'm Lena's twin sister, and they want to see me, they want to look at me, they want to compare. Oh, she does this like that. They're getting a big ball, and we're getting no enjoyment out of this at all. So here you go. These are the things that I think, if someone wants to knock me off, because I'm telling the truth, and they've been carrying secrets all these years, these are the things that I need you to know, Lena, that I haven't told you about. First of all, I'm quite sane. But before you figure out what's going on, you feel like you're losing your mind. That's the crazy makers around you. That's your family trying to convince you what is untrue is true, and your mind thinking, how could that be? That seems weird. What I'm bothered the most about when this happens, you know, my entire life, we have a sixth sense. We have something that keeps us safe, like animals do in the wild. Maybe a crunch in the ground, and, you know, we're alert. And our families have taught us to distrust our own instincts. I've come 100%. You can't mess with me. And when you lie to me, I just listen to what you're saying, like with grace. Oh, no. Like I said, I'm O positive. Oh, no, we're A blood type. Yeah, my son's A. I passed off an O and an A. Our dad had O. So your mom was A, but the O's dominant. So she told me what I needed to know. But she was trying to let me know, oh, no, that I couldn't be because they're all A blood type. But she had a big kick, which I think is really cruel, that we're not even Italian. She knows that you're not Italian, and you've invested so much time in this Italian community, and she knows where I'm completely unrelated to the people I was raised with. And then they had, here we go. I'm going to start over again. Lena, we're born December 25th, 1963. I won't tell you what hospital, but we had our baby pictures taken in Ithaca, New York, where my father had a black and white movie theater that taught, he was in the film industry. And so we got our baby pictures. There's probably twin pictures there, but we have each individual one. And my family's stolen that, of course, because that's going to be proof, or they think I might figure it out. I figured it out. It's already figured out. All the evidence is out there. It's as obvious as the nose on their face. They think they've stolen all the contents of my storage unit with baby books and everything, like that's going to somehow rescue them. And they stole my Airstream. I have a 31-foot Airstream trailer. It's been stolen. They want to remove any evidence so that I can't prove to you DNA is so developed and accurate now that people's secrets are falling by the wayside. It's impossible. And I'm not digging up our father. I already have. Never mind. But send in your DNA and find out. I love to challenge people because, prove that I'm not. Here's my blood. Go ahead and prove that I'm not. And they can't sue me because I'm telling the truth. And I'll quit telling the truth.